The newspaper claims Westminster's controversial former leader is to be severely criticised by the district auditor. It says Dame Shirley Porter is facing either disqualification from public office and multi-million pound surcharges, or a severe reprimand for misconduct. The claims centre on an inquiry by the district auditor into allegations of gerrymandering by the council to guarantee a Tory victory in Westminster at the May 1990 local elections. It's alleged millions of pounds were used to finance a housing policy aimed at manipulating the vote in eight key marginal wards. It's also claimed Westminster's Conservatives have been employing delaying tactics to prevent the auditor completing the report before the general election.
But it's also, I think, of great significance to the general stance of the Tory party. Some very senior figures in the Tory party, from Mrs. Thatcher downwards, have been involved over the years with what Lady Porter has been trying to achieve. And I think we need to know the truth of all that. I think it would be highly regrettable and a great blow to open government if this report was suppressed for purely party political advantage.
Labour would dearly love to win at least one of the two parliamentary seats in Westminster. Today's allegations come at the peak of the Cold War election campaigning. Conservatives here at Westminster are accusing Labour of using smear tactics. In a statement, Dame Shirley, who resigned as council leader last year, attacked the report as a mishmash of misinformation and disinformation, probably brought on by a severe bout of labour pains. She also said she'd not seen the report, and neither has anyone else.
The fact that The Guardian should come out now with a report based on unnamed sources can only, in our view, be connected with the general election. And this is part of the general smear campaign, which unfortunately the Labour Party seem to have embarked upon.
The district auditor has been unavailable for comment today, but his office confirmed that the report is not yet finished. It's thought unlikely it will be published before the election. Jane Ball, Thames News.